course, Jen does like 6 marathons in 1 weekend. So this is like just a warm up for you today, right, Jen?
Oh, well, this is a great opportunity for all of those people coming in from over 100 countries and all 50 states, their friends and their families coming with them. And, you know, sometimes those spectators want to get involved in the action, but like you're saying, not everybody wants to do 26.2. So today's Advocate Healthcare International Chicago 5K is the perfect opportunity for them to pound some pavement in the downtown area. We're seeing people from corrals A and B come through. Now, that's part of the first wave. The first wave has about 10,000 runners in it. We're seeing probably the first 3,000 to 5,000 runners coming down the streets through Chinatown. The crowds are starting to get packed. In fact, let's take a look at some of the crowds right here. Are you guys excited to be out here? Something that I always like talking to you about. Carrie's been doing this for 30 years now. And when Carrie started, what was the percentage of women in this race?
We had about 4% women, so very, very small percentage. So people say, what's our success? The success is women. Almost half of our participants are women. And
there's plenty of organizations out here on the Bank of America Chicago Marathon course. It's what makes it so great. So many people coming out to help support the runners. And one of those organizations is BioFreeze. I spoke with Amanda Shuda. She's the director of partnerships for BioFreeze, and this is what she had to say about mile 22.
I'm feeling a tightness in my calf, and I need BioFreeze in the middle of the race. What happens here?
So you'll come on into our zone. You'll find one of our trained brand ambassadors. He or she will spray it wherever you have issues. Just indicate where. You'll find that fast-acting relief. You'll cool the pain and you'll get back to your race.
Thank you.
But we did speak with one man from South Carolina who's run 23 marathons, and this time he's running for a cause that's close to his heart.
I am running for a specific cause today and tomorrow. I fundraise with a Run With Heart team, American Heart Association.
Now, he's not the only charity runner out here. In 2018, there were over 10,000 runners that raised money running for charity. They raised it for over 170 charities that are local, national, and global through the Chicago Marathon. And they brought in over $22 million. Now, everybody in Chinatown is extremely excited of what's going on, including Anita Lau, who is the co-chair of Chinatown Special Events. Anita, tell us what exactly Chinatown is doing today for this event.
Well, welcome to the windy Chinatown, the 21.5 mile. We welcome everybody with open arms. I want people to see our culture.
Thank you so much for your time, Blake. And the International 5K is happening in the downtown area. Street closures are going to be in place until about 9 a.m. this morning, then everything's opening back up. But the race finishes in Grant Park. And besides relieving the pain, there's also places out here that the runners can get nutrition. There's bananas at mile 19, another banana stand right before where we're at here in Chinatown. But there's gel, there's sports drink, and there's all sorts of organizations out here assisting the runners through the 26 miles. Now, Marion did say, I've run this before, so I know how much people are needed out here. If you're looking to come out and support the marathon runners, there's still hours left of them coming past mile 22 in Chinatown. And I'm Jen DeSalvo, live at Cermak in Wentworth in Chinatown.